Look who's just come round on the ponch, look. He's after some wood for his worktop. He's gonna convert his, what is it, your shed?
Shed.
Which was a shed, you know the shed we built. He's gonna convert, he converted it into a hot tub place, didn't you?
Yeah.
But now he's doing lawnmower work and he's doing scrapping work and all that. He wants to make it a shed again. So now he wants a worktop back in there. So lucky enough, I've got a bit of wood and we're gonna dig it out, cut it to length, he can take it. And then we're gonna have a look at a little Rotavator which he's picked up for nothing. And he's storing in my polytunnel.
Back in there, I'm filling it again.
Yeah? We just got rid of all that gear, now he's filling it up again. See you in a minute. Okie dokie, so let's have a look in here. Gary? Oh, hello, the old golf clubs. Look at the state of my Trotter's lawnmower, folks. Look, it's all full of dust and that. Look, remember that? I'm going to have to get this out one day and cut that paint right back. Look at the state of it, look. It's still in here, but it's absolutely filthy. That was a lovely gloss finish on that, if you remember rightly, when I finished it. And it's just totally neglected, Bert.
Well, you got a spare cover.
Hey? What?
Spare Briggs & Stratton cover.
I've got loads of Briggs & Stratton covers.
No, the pullover cover, rain protector.
Oh, sorry, yeah, once I clean it up, yeah. We'll dig that out sometime on my Retro Restore channel and get that up to scratch again, because it's a lovely old mower. Let's get this out of the way. Go on, lift that out of the way. We'll have to get this bit out first. Again, the hot tub's out of action at the moment. That's waiting on the part. What's that, an old blinking tripod there, look. Oh, that's an old broken tripod. That could have been thrown out, that. Don't need that. Put that through there for the moment.
Through there.
Right, it's a big old table. Hold it there. Where are you going to put it?
On this.
You want to cut this, you want to cut it face down. Because with a saw, it can chip. Now it's heavy, isn't it? Oh yeah, don't want to scratch it. Got it?
Yeah.
Lift. Right, that's it. Right, so, well, you want it 77?
No.
77 and a half inches. Get that marked up. Move that back. There you go. Happy days. Got a straight edge. Is that long enough? So how are you doing? What are you doing?
Mate, that's all right.
Coming up from the other side. Hey? Well, I say it's your bleaking marking.
Must not be cut down that end, right?
Well, that's a factory edge, that one there, look. Yeah, that edge was probably cut for the wall that it went in, which it was, and I don't think that would be square. So go from that end. That's a square edge, that's a factory edge. Yeah? Because that was cut for the wall. 77 and a half? See, I would have checked that, you see. Hold it. Go on in. Now you should get a straight line. Up there for thinking, down there for dancing. Those of you who didn't know, you can get a straight line. Normally, when you get these saws, this is normally a right angle. So if you find you've got a straight edge there and you put that, you butt that completely up to it without rocking it, then you've got a nice 90 degree angle there. So come in from the other way. As you could very well see there. That's it there, about there, isn't it? That's it. There we go. Right, are we hanging over that, yep, that's hanging over the edge of the tile, so we're going to cut that now. Right, let's zoom along that line then. I suppose I'm cutting it, am I? There we go. Let's turn it over. Let's have a look at that edge. Got it? That way. And again. Happy days, look at that. It's ideal. There you are. Ain't cost you a penny, look. See, I've got everything in this house. Right, so we got that. You got the other wood you can use from over there for the legs and that. So do you know what length the legs are going to be, or are you going to do that down your place? Yeah, see, we've got these. We can use these 3x2s as legs. That'd be ideal. Well, if you measure my, if you go in my log cabin, mine are worktop height. I've made them worktop height, you see. I think it's about 37 inches, isn't it? Something like that. To the base, 35, 36 inches. Make it 36. 3 foot, 12, 24, 36. Make it 36 inches. Well, if you go and measure the kitchen, that should be the same. Because I might have buggered it up in here, mightn't I? Right, yes, right, see what that is. 35 inches to the base. Say 35 inches. So you want to cut these 35 inches. There you go. That's one. There you go. That's it. How many are you going to put along there? One, two, three. Three legs at the front. Oh, come here, mummy. Mummy's here. Come here, we've got to do the draw show. Hold on, we've got to do our draw for our caption competition. Let's get these screws out of here. Is that all of them? What's that there? There's one there, look. No, there's one underneath it. See? You ain't looking, are you? Hold that down. Spinning. Hey? Go on in. Right on his. Hey, this is Gimmy's unit. Yeah, that's the old one. Oh, that, yeah. Right, okay, that's that. Let's put that there for the minute. Right, well, before we go any further, our caption competition, baby, come over here.
I want Gary to pick it, because I know.
Oh, put your chain around that way, look.
Does it make any difference?
Yeah, I like your chain. You don't want the link on show, baby. Right, so we've got six people. We had over 100 comments of Sharon, I think. And
some good ones and some rude ones.
Yeah, a lot of rude ones, Sharon said. We chose three each, and now we've put all six in the hat.
See, I really want my one to win.
And this is to win a ceramic mug with Butler's Empire on it. Gary, do you want to pull that out of there, pick one of them?
Pick it out.
Yeah.
In your own time.
Any time of day, Gary. Right, that one? Right, open it. Oh, go on then.
Yeah, you can read it.
Go on, mummy.
Oh, it's one of yours.
Oh, it's one of mine, apparently.
I'm not happy.
Come and read it.
Bullseye.
Oh, Bullseye Ant is the winner. And what has he wrote?
Christ's sake. Just needs a new diaphragm and gasket and she'll be as good as new.
That's you, baby. That was the winner. Bullseye Ant, if you go to our About page and just send me an email. Or send me an email to that email address there. I'll put it down there so you can see. Just send me an email. Give us your name and address, bud, and we'll send it off to you. Now, on our About page...
That's the one I wanted to win.
Eh? Yeah. On our About page... No, that's not right, Shell. What am I talking about?
Community page.
No. Oh, sorry, yeah, on our community page. Because we were going to do the draw on the Friday, Sunday, and we didn't because we were so busy working in the garden, I just said, oh, the draw's been delayed until today because of the work we've been doing in the garden. And just to show people what I was doing in the garden, Shell, I put a picture on there, right, of me working in the garden with a wheelbarrow. Shell, people thought it was another caption competition. They've been leaving comments below that.
You're not reading properly, are you? You just seeing a picture.
That's not a caption competition. That's
Billy
just
Billy.
Showing you that I was doing work in the garden. So that's not a caption competition. But anyway, we will do another one. But we're going to leave it for a couple of weeks or so. That means we've only got one mug to give away for Butler's Empire channel anyway. So that's that. So thank you very much, Bullseye Ant.
Thank
you've won.
Well done.
Yeah. We'll have a look at that lawnmower in a minute. Let's just cut these legs to length and then we'll do that. Right, he's got this old Rotavator here, so let's get this out and just see. He hasn't started it. Have you tried to start it?
No, the bloke was going to try yesterday, but he couldn't do
it. Right, well, we'll dig this out and just see if we can get this started. This is going to be restored on, I don't know, either Retro Restore or his channel yet. We ain't decided yet. Let's have a look at it. It's a Qualcast Rotavator. Is it, what's it called? A Cultimatic Super. And it's all there apparently, but has it got any fuel in the tank? He's got a spare carb.
That's the original.
Right, and he said he couldn't get it to run slow or something, didn't he?
Yeah.
But he bought this one second hand by the looks of it as well. Has it got fuel in it?
Not really. It's ending there, look.
Oh, right, we'll get some more fuel in. Yeah, there's a bit of shit in the tank as well.
Yeah.
So get that, go and get some fuel. You want my fuel as well, I take it?
Well, we'll use a bit.
So I don't know if that's original. That's for the gearbox by the looks of it. Brings the driving, I would say. All right, so you've got some petrol. Again, it'll all be stripped down, powder coated. Should do it, shouldn't it? All right, at least it's covering the bottom now anyway, so put that on there. Is there a fuel tap on it? Yeah, there is. So that's a bit of leakage around that by the looks of it, look.
Okay.
But it's off at the moment, so if I turn it on. Right, okay, it's on now, but.
It's got a little tickler. He said the fuel comes out of there.
What, out of where?
Out of there.
What, it's cracked?
No, he said it's meant to or something.
Oh, yeah.
You farm it, but I don't know.
That looks like the body might be cracked on there.
Same on there,
look. Oh, a little hole there. There is a little hole there, isn't there? Yeah, I can see it now. I've not heard that before, but that don't seem to be filling up.
It's not firing, is it?
Don't know if there's enough. Yeah, that's the on position.
Look.
But there's no fuel filling up from the fuel tap.
That's blocked.
Maybe. Maybe the tap's blocked, yeah. Yeah, that's definitely off. See, it's not really moving. Or it's the fuel cap might be blocked. If we just take that off for a minute. Yeah, look, there's nothing coming through the fuel, is there? Fuel tap. Well, there's a bit of fuel maybe there, look. Or is it? Oh, here we go. It's like there's a little vacuum there, isn't there?
Yeah.
I don't know whether or not that's going to be blocked or not. Well, we can give it a pull start anyway, we'll see what happens. If not, we can fire some
easy start
up the exhaust or the intake there, don't we? That's the filter there, look, it's just a bit of wire wall someone's put in there, look. So whether that's right or not, I don't know, but all right, okay, well, just take that carb off of there for a minute, just in case it vibrates if it does start. So has it got a choke? Just a tickler?
Tickler on it.
Yeah. Okay, that's the cutout. Right, see what happens if you can try and pull it in. Oh, fuel's coming out now, yeah. Right, just try it on max, because he said it wouldn't run on minimum, didn't he?
Yeah.
Right. Okay, it's not going to fire, is it? So we'll have that plug out. And we'll see what if we're getting any fuel go through to the plug. And also bring the easy start out as well, Gary. Right, well, we'll just check if we got spark first of all. Whip that plug out there. Again, we don't know. He's not even looked at it before, so we can't really say whether we have or haven't got any fuel getting through. But the plug's bone dry, look. So that's bone dry. Now, whack a bit of that easy start in there. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll check for spark first of all, just while we're here. Right, I'll hold that there. Right, I'll just give it a kick over. Hold on, go on. Go on. Yeah, we've got spark. So we've definitely got spark there. So we'll put some easy start in the spark plug hole.
I think he did tell me that at one point the fuel was coming out the air filter, so...
Oh, is it? Well, that's float height then, yeah, go on. Right, whack that in there. If it coughs and splutters into life on that, see, that might be enough to pull some fuel through. As long as it kicks over, that's all we're interested in. Yeah. Well, it's bone dry. Go on, it was bone dry anyway, wasn't it? There is a choke, is there? Right, go on then, try that. Ah, it did fire. It's a choke out now, you said.
I presume that.
Is that a choke or is that a lever? It's pouring petrol out. Put it on fast speed. It's trying to start, isn't it? Right, hold it there. Just give that a bit more of a tickle. I don't think this carb's working. There we go. Oh, hello. It's trying to start, isn't it? Yeah, it's carburetor. It's carburetor. It's not working. It's pouring out fuel there. So this is the one he's put on. So at least we know it's going to run. So turn that fuel tap off over there now. And I think you'll safely say that that will be a good candidate for restoration. So just try it one more time.
My fuel's off now.
Yeah, it's all right, don't matter. It should have enough fuel getting there. Yeah, it's running. It did try to run then. Yeah. Yeah, all right, then we'll leave it there. But yeah, it's going to run. It don't pose too much of a problem for us once we get that carb off and sorted.
We might as well clean that one up, innit?
Yeah, that's the original one that came with it. So we'll clean that up, take it apart, put it through the ultrasonic cleaner. Is that, what's that little flap there, look, at the bottom? Oh, it is a choke, look. So if you hold the carb up that way, I was just showing this, look. So if you see that little brass lever on the end there, that in line is to choke open, and that way is it fully choked. So flow with it, blocking it off, just like a fuel tap. Brilliant. Don't know, they got a bolt on there. Have they got a bolt through here? He got two mud guards free with it, apparently for this model. Would that be a like that, bolt under there somewhere, like that sort of thing? I don't know. That don't go on that way, does it? Not unless he's actually bought the wrong ones. I would imagine they'd go under there, but you could probably make them fit anyway, just by kicking them a little bit. But I can't see where else they would go. That's why he's probably not fit them, because they're not the right ones.
Well, give me a new blade.
Yeah, and new blades he's got for it as well. We just undo this. That one's a bit, had a little pipe adapter on it. Someone's welded a tube on there, I noticed. If we lift this up, look. That's the old jockey wheel in the belts, look. So it's all very prehistoric, isn't it? So, again, is it two speed? Look, what's the second pulley there?
I think it's got forward and reverse.
Oh, is it? But you've got two sets of gears there. That wouldn't affect forward and reverse. Because both pulleys are on the same thing. They're just a smaller one there. Which means it alters the speed of it, I would imagine. That belt's had it though, look, it's got a big crack in it. So yeah, I'm not sure. That's the jockey wheel there, which is just linked up to that chain, but it's a bit crude, but I think it does the job though, doesn't it?
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah, anyway, so there's a bolt that goes through there, look, with an R-pin, which pulls that off. But the one on the other side, although it's got the R-pin going through it, someone's welded this tube on here, look. For some reason, I don't know why that is. So that's something else which has got to be looked at. Maybe this outer boss here broke off, maybe, I don't know, on this outer one. And they just welded the tube off there, on there. So I'm not sure. But again, it'll get sorted. Yeah, because this one's got a built-in mud guard on it. Yeah. I think he's bought the wrong ones there, that's the problem there. So there you go. Yeah, choke is off now. Look, in that position, that's choke on. Choke off, there we go. Oh well, you learn something new every day. That's the little Rotavator project Gary's got coming up. Maybe on his channel, maybe on my channel.
Who knows?
Who knows? So that's it. That's the Rotavator project. I'll let you push that in, seeing as it's yours. What's them wheels straightening up as well? It's a bit bowed going out, wasn't it?
That one is,
yeah.
Well, they meant to come off when you're rotavating,
he said. Oh, do they?
You take the wheels off.
Oh, right.
You've got to sink them legs into the floor.
Oh, I see. Oh, right, okay. Don't know. Right, okay then folks, we'll leave it there for this one. Hope you've enjoyed that. We've got plenty to do, as you can see, and we'll be putting videos out as and when. Hopefully we've got a lot of work happening in the garden this weekend. You'll probably see that on Butler's Empire channel. And yeah, thanks very much. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, ring that little notification bell, set your preferences to all, that way you get notified every time I upload a video. Anyway, thanks very much. I'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.